day's project, but I didn't want to actually make it until I started recording. One of the first things we're gonna do is I looked it up because I was completely having a brain fart yesterday. How to make fiber mesh. And that simply is collecting some of the creep vine. We collect a couple of those and we can make fiber mesh. As soon as I make contact with it. Alright, I got three inventories full, so I might have to go back out. So, in the fabricator, fiber mesh won't even show up until after you've collected some creep vine. Odd, yeah, but there you have it. So now, what we're gonna work on making is we're gonna try to make our radiation suit. And I don't know how much fiber mesh we need. We'll find out here in a second. Okay, so we need to collect one more piece of the creep vine. We'll go grab that real quick. And then in this video, we are going to start building our base. Just so that we can get out of the life pod itself. And we will see how much time we have left before we figure out what we'll do after that. So now we have these two. You keep hearing that volcano in the background. It's only 70 meters away. It's so close. All right. And as you also see, we have another transmission, so we'll check that out here in a minute. And we want the fiber, or we want the radiation suit so that we can get near the ship. There's a lot of items that you can collect and scan near the ship. We will also need to go into the ship to get sea moth fragments and the prawn. So there's quite a bit that we need to go into the ship for. And we just need to make sure that we're protected. All right. So if you, as you see now, we have the radiation gear on. So that protects us. Let's see. I wonder what kind of tools can we create so far? What shows up? Okay, so in the next video, I'm going to show you where Diamond Island is, and that way we can go get ourselves some diamonds. We're going to need the laser cutter for when we go in to the ship. So now that we've got our radiation suit, I think what we I oh darn it! The one thing I forgot we have to make before we can start building a base is. We need the habitat builder. So we need to figure out what we need for the computer chip. Okay, I have silver ore, so I think all we need is table coral. That's actually not too bad. Kind of got lucky there. And this is your table coral. We kind of got lucky there. Silver ore can be kind of a pain, but I forgot we got lucky and found one yesterday. I need to grab the silver ore out. All right, so now that we have this, normally we want to explore around and find ourselves a really good base or location for a base. So we're going to drive around and see what we can find. Last time I built a base, I built it where there were a lot of those little pink piranha-type fish. It was the red seaweed beds, kind of like down there. They were quite a hassle, but we're probably going to do the same thing again. Maybe a little different spot. We're not that far from Life Pod. I don't really see a reason. As time goes on, we will probably end up building another base farther out, maybe once we get in the farther storyline. But right now, it doesn't hurt to be that close. Kind of run back and forth. All right, so we're gonna start with, I like the X compartments. What do we need for a hatch? We're gonna need glass and titanium. Okay. How much do we have of either? I could make glass now, that's no problem. But we need to get titanium. Oh, I think right by that shark, that sand shark, that looks like a sea moth glider or sea moth fragment. So we're gonna try to get it. And not get killed. Alright. There we go. We've got this a piece of the sea moth glider now. Oh look, we got lucky, we just got copper. Oh, better go get some oxygen. We need to find some titanium, and a lot of times I really like finding the, I'll look on rocks because it does give you a chance for copper or silver, but when I'm strictly looking for metal, I love finding the debris because it's 4 for 1. Now that we've got ourselves some metal, we are going to get that stuff made. While we're in here, we need to get ourselves another med kit, because you can never have too many. And I need to grab, oh, actually, I already had a water on me. Okay. Now we're going to go back down, and now I actually have to refind the base, because I forgot to put my beacon down. I always try to have a beacon made right away, to make it easier to find. So I hope I'm going in the right direction. That looks like the type of things we built on. And this game does still suffer from a lot of lag. Still waiting for a patch to come out to fix that. And it looks like we are out of power. And I think I put my battery away in the life pod, because I made one specifically knowing that we were low on power. We're going to do a little bit of slow swimming for the time being. And find our base. Put you. I was not thinking at all when I forgot to put that beacon down. Dang it. I'm sorry for wasting your time on this. I think I'm going to head back and get that battery, unless. Oh, is that it there? I think I found it. All right, good, because otherwise I was going to have to go get the battery so we could find this faster. Don't really need the sea glide out since it's not really working right now anyways. Oh, and we get a little bit of a freeze there. And another one. Okay, let's see. Alright, now we can just jump in here and get some oxygen. Oh, no, that's right. We don't have power, so we're not getting oxygen. Now let's get up there before I drowned. I got the beacon put in place. A little bit of freezing there. You know, just make the game a little more exciting. Okay, so for power, we're gonna need some more crystals. Because we will build several of these solar panels. So we just need to get some quartz. Then we'll have power in our base. Make life much better. Still awfully deep. Don't really feel like having to fight that. Now we just need to find ourselves. Oh, right there's a couple quartz. Want to find four so I can have two solar panels going. That's a good start. That's the volcano getting ready to erupt again. There we go. Right on the verge of the volcano. I need to do is catch a fish real quick, too. Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Ah! Get back here. These guys are actually pretty slow. They're about the easiest ones to catch. Those in the bladder fish. Some oxygen. Cook that fish up. Okay, so now we are going to. What did I do with that battery? I don't see it. Disturbing. Oh, you know what? I used it when I made the habitat builder, I believe. I need to make another battery. That's okay, I can do that in another video or in between videos. I want to get power up and running before I end this video. That, and I'm going to build a multi-purpose room. And that way we can get our planters built for growing our own food and water. Then no more chasing fish. So, thanks to the island that we found in the last video, we now are able to start building a self-sufficient base, which makes the entire game way more fun and easy. I personally like to build my base out in the open like this because once you have your observation room and stuff, you really have some pretty views to look at. But really, you can build it wherever you feel. If you like seclusion in a cave, if you like the moss bed or the creep vine beds, it's really whatever you prefer. Okay, so now we can come and get some oxygen. And we can come back out. And we are going to build a couple multi-purpose rooms. Except that we're paused. Or lag freezing. They definitely need to get the new patch out as soon as possible. Alright. Now we have. I will need to, after I do. We're going to keep living out of the life pod for the most part because I need to build a fabricator to truly work out of this place. But we're not going to be doing that right away. So we definitely will still kind of be traveling back and forth. Okay, so I can only build two at the moment. That's fine, we'll need more titanium. So before I end this video, I'm gonna go get the food, bring it back to the base, and just basically show you it planted. Once that's done, we will end this for the day, and we will be planning our Diamond Island trip once I've collected a battery and create another beacon. And I'll do that in between shows. And after using that sea glide, swimming feels so slow. I really need to build some fins. I usually don't, to be honest, because I get the sea glide so quick in the game that I don't usually build the fins, but it is pretty good to do so. I'm also going to check, as I said I would earlier, and I've completely spaced it, we will check the incoming message and see what they've got for us. So when you do plant the food, it usually takes a couple days for it to grow. Now, I also had that other plant that I had picked up, but I am not seeing it. So I'm probably going to have to go back to the island for that. I somehow did not get that. All right, so let's see what the communication relay is. Life pod 4, coordinates attached. Since planet fall, pod has not sustained damage, no crew members have disembarked, and zero life signs have been detected on board. Recommend investigation. So we will have to do that in an upcoming video as well. Do such a fun swim. Feels so slow. All right. And really, you only need to grab one of each plant. If I had grabbed more, it wouldn't have really been that big of a deal. It's like, since I did grab two of these melons, they'll grow fast, or I'll have more growing at the same time. But it's really not necessary, because once one plant grows, you'll be able to pull seeds off of them and plant more. So if you don't have a huge inventory to grab a bunch all at once, really no big deal. I think that is it for this episode. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, please comment. If you have anything you'd like me to show or see, please feel free to comment that as well. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next episode.